Good evening, everyone. I'm meteorologist Haley LaPointe. Here's a look at your updated forecast. Hey, some of us came away with half a foot of snow through the overnight hours in this morning. Keene, 7 inches in Meredith, Nashua, about 6 inches. Same thing in Concord, Deerfield, a little bit less than that. But this was some fluffy snow that moved through and made the roads very treacherous through the day. And even this evening, yes, they're improved, but the problem is temperatures are still well below freezing, and we have some freezing drizzle and freezing rain moving through. There's even more off toward the south and west of us here. Eventually overnight, the temperatures are actually going to warm, so much so that any rain that comes in will come down as plain old rain, and we won't have to worry about the freezing threat. But I would say from now until about midnight, there certainly is the threat all across the northeast, but especially in New Hampshire, of some slippery road conditions. Here's the setup. We have a low pressure system off toward our west here, and the snow that we got earlier was actually part of a warm front that moved through. So air coming from the south will start to mean warmer air coming up toward us. So overnight, the temperatures will go from the teens and 20s where they are now up into the 30s and eventually even the 40s during the day tomorrow before this cold front sweeps through, and then some much colder air arrives by the time we get back to Monday. So really it's a one day warm up tomorrow with temperatures like what you see down in Washington, D.C. near 40, and some temperatures maybe in the upper 40s, close to 50 in southern New Hampshire. But then look out toward Minneapolis and Fargo. Those cold temperatures make a return by the time we get to Monday and the start of the holiday week. So yes, we've got ups and some downs over the next couple of days here with our temperatures, and by midweek we'll start to get a little bit closer to the average. So here's what happens. The timeline of all of this. We're mostly cloudy tonight with areas of freezing drizzle and also the patchy freezing rain. So very slippery driving conditions. But then by 6 a.m., you notice that this whole thing turns green and even some yellows and oranges, indicating heavy rain. So the temperatures will have gone up by that time. Once we get to the afternoon, this is noontime itself, we'll probably have some breaks in the action, but there will be some more scattered showers moving through. Then the cold air settles in, and there is a small chance that we could have a flash freeze after this rain has moved through. Hopefully there'll be enough drying time so that the roads would dry up before the cold air came in, but that's questionable. So it could be slick driving conditions again on Sunday night and early on Monday morning. But Monday, we're back to full sunshine. So in terms of rain fall, well, we'll take what we can get. We're still in a drought technically, although you're not going to absorb it through the snow and through the frost, but we'll get about maybe an inch in some locations that get lucky with some of the heavier downpours of rain. So overnight tonight, the temperature's on their way up. So that'll be that temperature reading there, 27, probably happens around midnight. Then the temperatures go up. It'll be slippery. The rain moves in. Here are the temperatures for tomorrow in the 40s. And yes, maybe even a few southern communities getting close to 50 degrees. Monday, Tuesday, sunny skies. Temperatures start to become a little bit more mild by Wednesday. Thursday afternoon is when our next storm system comes through, and this one looks like it could bring rain or snow showers. It clears on Friday, and then so far, Christmas Eve on Saturday, looking good with sunshine and a temperature near 40.